delays between Northeast Georgia and the South Carolina state line. News 4's Angela Rodriguez has more.
Here's how it's going to work. Starting in the morning, crews will start on the inside lane here at exit 173. They're going to pave their way up to the state line. Then they'll come back. Then they'll do the outside lanes. And then they'll come back again. And it is expected to take several months.
With the weather warming up, drivers are making plans for adventures and road trips. Unless you're a road warrior, the welcome to Georgia will soon be spoiled by a major roadblock.
What I hate more than anything is sitting at a dead stop at a bottleneck on the interstate.
For the first time in 10 years, road crews will resurface a 7-mile stretch of I-85 from exit 173 to the South Carolina state line.
A couple days from now, it's going to make it a lot slower.
It's a slow process moving forward thanks to federal stimulus money. Drivers making the trek to Atlanta on this busy stretch of road hope South Carolina is next on the list.
It's not bad right here. Parts of it in South Carolina are terrible.
To minimize the impact on drivers, crews will only work overnight. But to keep the crew safe, one lane of the interstate will have to be shut down.
They're going to have traffic backed up all the way through the state.
All lanes will be open during the day, but those who live in the area are still planning to steer clear.
Yeah, you just automatically think, oh gosh, you know, I'm going to have to rework my whole schedule in the morning.
The work is expected to last through July 31st.
Here's what DOT officials say. Crews will only work one direction at a time, so whichever way you see those trucks pointed, that's where you can expect delays. Angela Rodriguez, W.